So you're thinking about moving to Boca Raton, Florida? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you the pros and the cons, the yin and the yang, the positives and the negatives, the good and the bad of living right here in my home city of Boca Raton. So let's get into it right now. If this is your first time to the channel and we haven't met before, my name's Larry Mastropieri. I'm the broker owner of the Mastropieri Group based right here in Boca Raton, Florida. And we get calls from people like yourself every day thinking about making that smooth move here to South Florida. So don't hesitate to reach out whether you're moving sooner or later. And in the meantime, hit the subscribe button. Give me a like in advance because I know you're going to love this video. Now let's get into the pros and cons. The first pro to bring up about Boca Raton is that its school systems, public and private, are ranked some of the highest in the area. And that is a huge draw, as you can imagine, for families. So this has become a very family-oriented community here in Boca Raton because of these great school systems. On top of that, Boca Raton has four universities within the city limits, one of the largest being Florida Atlantic University with about 30,000 students. And I think this is all generally positive because I think it brings a young, innovative, positive energy to the city itself. It also supports the local businesses a lot. And if you're a resident of Boca Raton and you have kids that went to the public school and now they want to go to the university, FAU being an example, they're very close to the school, which is great. And I'm actually a graduate of Florida Atlantic University. I have an undergrad in mechanical engineering from there and a master's in business. So I generally think FAU is a great school and it's growing every year. The next pro is safety. Boca Raton, generally speaking, is one of the safer cities here in South Florida. It ranks below the national average for violent crime and just above the national average for property crime. But overall, the city is very well known for being very safe and family oriented. Now let's throw some cons into the mix here because it's not all fairy tales and sugar plums here in the city of Boca Raton. I'm not really sure what a sugar plum is, but let's keep it moving. Let's talk about the cost of living. The cost of living in the city of Boca Raton is about 20% higher than the US national average. So that's not ideal. Also, the city of Boca Raton is very well known for being wealthy. It's ranked the third wealthiest city in the state of Florida based on the average household income. So you have a very wealthy city with above average cost of living. So there's positives and negatives to that. For example, it costs more money to live here, so that's not great. But the benefit is you get all the infrastructure of a wealthy city. The city has a very high tax base, so they make a lot of money, so they can afford to keep the city very clean. They can afford to invest in their schools. They can afford to invest in infrastructure and the downtown areas. And so because of that, you get this great city with great infrastructure, a lot of amenities. And I can say Boca Raton does a very good job of spending their money very well. And so it shows here in the city for sure. Let's stick with the cons here. Let's talk about the cost to purchase a new home. So generally speaking, the cost of a new home here in Boca Raton is higher than some of the surrounding cities. And because of that, insurance is typically higher, taxes are typically higher because the purchase price is higher. So I'd say that's a relatively big con. Another con for the city of Boca Raton is that there's not a lot of land. It's pretty well developed. And so there's positives and negatives to that. The negative is there's not a lot of new construction. And if there is new construction available here in the city, it's either being sold by lottery, it's selling out immediately, and it is definitely not cheap. One of the downsides of higher density and low availability of land is that when builders do eventually get their hands on these lots, they really try to squeeze in the amount of homes they can fit there. And what that typically looks like is building zero lot line communities. And most people don't know what a zero lot line community is, but it happens here occasionally in South Florida. You'll find homes that have zero lot lines. And so that means that basically on one side of the property, there is no setback. So your house is built right on your neighbor's property line. So your neighbor can basically touch your wall of your property while still standing on their property. So that just means that the lots are really small and you're really close to your neighbors. And so it's not as desirable as a home that has a good setback on both sides of the property with a nice lot and a nice backyard. While there isn't a lot of new land to build on here in Boca, I feel like Boca does do a good job of keeping things updated, looking new, looking fresh, looking clean, especially in the downtown area. For example, the retail buildings definitely keep their facades updated really nicely. And there's also a lot of new condo construction in the area. So those new big buildings look really nice here in downtown. So generally speaking, Boca has a good updated feel to it. And while the city doesn't have a lot of land for new development and new beautiful homes to be built, it has done an incredible job of reserving areas for parks and recreation. And some of these parks are in incredible locations that would have otherwise been developed into massive condo projects. So they've done a great job, despite maybe some of the pressure they encountered over the years, of keeping these parks intact and having these beautiful locations where the public can go hang out. Some great examples of parks in Boca Raton that have incredible locations can be seen right on the beach. You got Red Reef Park right next to Gumbo Limbo Nature Preserve, South Beach Park, which is right in the heart of Boca Raton, and Spanish River Park on the north side of Boca Raton. All great green natural areas with a ton of parking and a ton of amenities in these parks. They're super well kept, and there are no high-rise condos in these areas. It's amazing. Now, one of the big things that I value about living here in the city of Boca Raton, and this is a big pro for me, is its location. Whenever I think about real estate, location is a huge factor. I put a lot of weight on that, and I try to coach my clients that way as well. They should really think about the location they're buying in. So let's talk about it. So Boca Raton, if you live here, you're extremely close to the downtown. And the downtown is awesome for many reasons. You got restaurants, bars, shops, all the actions going on in downtown Boca Raton. It's super clean. It's just really nice. And then you're very close to Delray Beach's downtown, which is like 10 minutes away from where I live. So Delray Beach is a huge tourist destination, very popular. It's becoming more and more popular, and they got a lot going on there too. So if you want to switch up your vibe from Boca to Delray, you can easily pop into Delray, go downtown, enjoy a lot of the bars, a lot of the nightlife, restaurants, beaches, and a lot of the action that's going on over there very easily. And then Deerfield Beach is directly to your south with a completely different vibe, pretty low key, beautiful beach, a lot going on over there too, some good restaurants. So you can go right to Deerfield Beach if you want within 5-10 minutes. And then furthermore, Boca Raton is positioned directly in the middle of South Florida. So you are extremely close to Miami within an hour, Fort Lauderdale, 30 minutes, West Palm Beach, 30 minutes, and those all have international airports as well. So you're extremely close to three major international airports. So travel is super easy here if you live in Boca Raton. So for all those reasons, Boca Raton is a great location, and that's a big pro for me. Another thing, now that I mentioned transportation, I have to bring up the Brightline stop that's relatively new, located right in the city's downtown. The Brightline train is meant to be a fast train to get you to the major cities here in South Florida. So for example, it pretty much only has a few stops, and it stops in places like Fort Lauderdale, and Miami, and West Palm as an example. There's a couple more along the way, obviously Boca. So Boca is very privileged to have a stop right here in the city, right next to downtown. And one day it's supposed to stop in Orlando, which is great, and also Jacksonville and Tampa, hopefully. So this train will provide access to all of Florida or the major cities in Florida. And right now it's great to just jump in that train, go to Miami for a day or an evening, and not have to drive or deal with the traffic. So this is a great amenity, and it's relatively new to our city. Let's throw in another con here real quick, because I feel like I'm giving you a lot of pros, and that's because I like the city of Boca Raton, one of the reasons why I live here. So let's talk about the transient population and a lot of the tourism here. I define the transient population as people who spend part of their year here, part of their year somewhere else in the world. An example of that might be the snowbirds who spend their winters here and then go back to wherever they're from in the summer. So the big con about a transient population or just this destination type location is that you may not always get that tight-knit community feel And why is that? Because part of the population may not be here half the year, so they might not have that full community commitment like they do in some other parts of the country. So it's important that you talk to your realtor about the type of community you're looking for to make sure you get what you want, to make sure you get that right vibe in that community you want, because there are definitely communities here, specifically in Boca Raton, that foster that community type atmosphere. But now let's get into why I think the geography of Boca Raton is a big pro. First, Boca Raton has its own inlet. So if you have a boat and you're in the intercoastal in Boca Raton, it's quick and easy to get out to the ocean. So this means that if you own property on the water in Boca Raton that's navigable, such as intercoastal property or canal property, it's very quick and easy to get your boat out to the ocean, which means your property value is likely higher than property that's on the water in other areas that don't have quick access to an inlet. Second, Boca Raton has three bridges that give you access to the beaches over the intercoastal, which is more than some of the other cities in the area. And why is this a pro? It's a pro because if you own property close to a bridge on the mainland, your value is typically a little better than properties that are not that close to a bridge that don't have quick access to the beach or the island. Third, Boca Raton has skinny intercoastals. And skinny intercoastals means short little bridges, which means it's easy to walk, bike, or jog across the bridge if you live on the mainland to get to the beach. And so this is a good thing for property values for the mainland because it's very easy to get access to the beach. Another advantage geographically for Boca Raton is that Boca has a fair amount of canal front and waterfront property as compared to places like Delray Beach, who has limited canal or waterfront property. So if you're looking for waterfront homes, it's maybe easier to find one in Boca Raton than in some other cities. Let's move on to another con. Let's talk about country club and membership equity communities. When buyers first start shopping in Boca Raton, sometimes they're not always aware of these membership equity golf country club communities that exist here in Boca. And so they start sending me listings from Zillow and other internet websites that look awesome, that are priced really reasonable, and they don't know what they're looking at. They don't know that they're looking at these membership equity communities with these big buy-ins, $100,000, $150,000 buy-ins, which, by the way, you don't usually get back when you sell the property. You don't get that buy-in back when you sell. You typically give it to the community and that's it. And then also the carry costs associated with living in these communities. So when I coach them up, when I educate them on this, they quickly realize that this probably isn't a fit for them. And they decide they're going to shop outside of the country club communities. And they find out that homes outside of the country club communities aren't as cheap as the homes inside the country club communities for obvious reasons. And so they get a little disappointed. So I'd say that's a con for most buyers, but buyers that want the country club or the membership equity buy-in deal, it's a great area to do that because there are so many great country clubs in Boca Raton. Let's wrap this up with one last pro. I want to talk to you about puppies. We at the Mastropieri Group love puppies. We also love all animals. My sister specifically has had, I don't know, five animals and a pig for a long period of time. So we are definitely pet friendly here at the Mastropieri Group, and Boca Raton is absolutely pet friendly too. Boca Raton has a ton of different dog parks. They also have a dog beach where you can bring your dog right over at Spanish River Park. It's called Bark Beach. And you also will find that people push their dogs around in strollers down here. You'll see that at the mall. You'll see that at Meisner Park as an example. You'll see that at dinner maybe. So it is a big thing to be very pet friendly here in the city of Boca Raton. Thanks for watching our video about the pros and cons of living here in Boca Raton. If you watched this video to the end, which likely you did because you're here at the end with me right now, hit that subscribe button, please. Hit the like button so we can get this out to more people like you. And if you are thinking about moving to the area, don't hesitate to give me a call. Send me an email, shoot me a text. We'd love to be the ones to help you make that smooth move to South Florida.